In today's video, I'm going to be painting one of my favourite miniatures, the Yuqing Sujian. Not that one. This one. There are a number of miniatures that got me excited to start collecting Infinity. The Hassassin Lasik with viral sniper rifle, Magarabagagalagard, and the Hakizlam, the Yuqing starter set Operation Red Veil with all of its beautiful minis. But one miniature stood out to me as being above and beyond the others, and that was the Sujian. There is something about its combat form's pose that makes it so menacing, holding the knife ready and craning its neck and most definitely looking down on anything it is facing. I bought the model along with the Shazvasti army pack nearly a year ago and it has been sitting waiting, but now I am going to paint it. Usually I approach a miniature with one particular painting technique to try and focus on, but for this model I wanted it to look as good as my current painting skill can get it. So with that in mind, I was going to attempt a variety of techniques to see if I could have them complement one another. My Yuqing have a green and red paint scheme. The vast majority of the armor was going to be green, so I decided to pull out the airbrush to help me try and make a smooth blend. Now, my regular Iwata Neo had been causing me all sorts of problems, and I eventually ended up snapping the needle cap trying to clean it. I could have tried to buy a replacement and get my Neo working, but I had a hunch that it was a far bigger problem than that I had. So instead, I used the same money to buy myself a cheapo airbrush on AliExpress. Expecting it to be awful and break soon, I can safely say it has been pretty damn good so far, far easier to use and clean than my Neo. I don't expect it to last, but it is a great stopgap before I upgrade to an Eclipse, and even then, it has loads of parts that I will be able to scavenge from its corpse. With layers from dark green to bright green to yellow on the model, I was happy with the gradients and it was time to get the brush out. The airbrush helped me save a lot of time, but it hasn't finished the job needed to complete the armor. The next phase had me edge highlighting with a bright green and recess shading with a dark blue green. This was to help give the edges definition, shape, and greater contrast. With the armor now defined, it was time to start adding all the other colors to the model. The main two that I had to add was the NMM steel of the machine parts under the armor and red trim. Starting with the majority of the steel, I base coated these areas black and then built progressive highlights of gray. I wanted to keep these areas fairly dark to contrast the bright green of the armor. Next was to add the red trim. I chose a vibrant red as the base color and placed it on the neck, biceps, and knife grip. These were then recess shaded with a crimson red and highlighted with an intense red. This then finished the painting for the color scheme and I could imagine where the model was going to be. Time to paint the gun and knife. For the gun, my Yuqing have a very futuristic aesthetic in the vein of Mass Effect. So rather than metallics, I paint the majority of the guns in a white plasteel style. To do this, I paint the gun in ivory for these areas and then coat in Agrax Earthshade. Once dry, this is then re-highlighted with ivory. The other areas of the gun will then get black to grey NMM. The knife gave me a chance to add some varying colour into the model. I decided to paint it my blue steel NMM. This starts by painting from the darkest colour up to the lightest in ever decreasing sizes. When sketching the reflections, I purposefully randomised the areas with differing sizes. The light should follow the same strokes of the brush, but their size can vary. If your reflections are too similar or follow an exact pattern, they don't look natural. As you then add the lighter and lighter layers, it ends up looking like reflections or glow off of a blade. With the model close to finished with a clean paint job, I worked on the base. I removed the model from its base, which I had previously prepared with an epoxy putty stamped with rocky texture. I wanted an urban rubble theme for the base, so I based it all in black and used a makeup sponge to apply dark grey and light grey. Then, to give it more texture, I added a red orange. According to the Sujian's description on the Corvus Belli store, its name translates to the Swift Sword. I wanted to add some freehand Chinese characters, and using Google Translate to help me, I found some characters that may translate to the same. I could not find a phrasing of Sujian, but I did find the same meaning from Kuaijian, so I decided to use these characters for my miniature. I wanted to put the characters on the shoulders of the model, so I began by taking a light grey and using a fine brush and, thanks to my Japanese study and understanding of stroke order, attempted writing the characters. Once I was happy with the result, I then traced these with black. The result wasn't perfect, but it came out better than expected. The model was looking almost finished but felt separate from his base. With the understanding that before his combat form he has been running on all fours, I went about weathering the feet and hands. To achieve this, I used a makeup sponge to apply brown and red orange. Now the model tied with its base more, and all it needed was some finishing touches with the eyes, gun highlights, and small detailing. To help protect the model and give its armor a shine, I applied a thinned down satin varnish, and when this was dry, the model was finished. I really like how painting a model with a variety of techniques can bring a paint job together. Airbrushing for smooth blends, edge highlights for definition, recess shading for depth, weathering for a sense of place, and freehand for a unique effect. I hope you enjoyed the video. I enjoyed painting this model and I look forward to putting him on the table with the rest of my Imperial service or playing him in Infinity Defiance. If you liked the video, please give a like and subscribe for more future content. Thanks and see you next time.